All right. I got it. I'll roll. Awesome. First of all, thanks for everybody jumping in this session for a quick 20 minutes. We're going to cover building a secure perimeter with AWS WAF in this session. My name is Justin Kirpius. I am a security specialist here at AWS. Been here for about 4 years, covering WAF, Shield, and a number of other security services. So we'll go ahead and jump in. We only have 20 minutes. What we're going to cover here is we're going to go over a use case that hopefully resonates with everybody here. We'll then talk about two services that we're going to deploy to deploy baseline security policy. I'll demo both of the deployment models, and then we'll bring it all together at the end to discuss why we showed both and what it means. So we'll start with the example. We'll start with the example. And again, hopefully you've experienced this, but typically we hear from customers they need to move fast. We need to have an application ready to roll. But in this case, we're going to use ABC Loans, which in their environment, security is very important because they're doing financial transactions. Also, we're not sure where the end users are going to be located through the world, but we know customer experience is very important, which means we have to have low latency and a good response time if this application is to take off. And then on top of all that, we have to be cost efficient. So whether it's the economic backdrop or launching applications that we're unsure if they're going to be successful, we need to have cost in mind. So that'll be the use case that we're going to cover. And so we're going to cover two services. The first one is Amazon CloudFront, which is our content delivery network. And the reason this becomes very important is because as we build applications and we need that experience to be very good for our users and low latency, that's what our content delivery network does, our CDN. And so all we're really doing here is we're bringing the experience for the end user closer to them no matter where they are in the world. The other reason that we're going to focus on CloudFront as one of the services is all of the locations throughout the globe are called points of presence or POPs. And in these points of presence that we're bringing that experience closer to the end user, we also have important security services in these locations. We have Shield Advanced, and then we also have AWS WAF, which will be the second service that we cover as far as what we're going to show as the demos to help build baseline security policy. So for our AWS WAF, it seamlessly integrates with the four services you see here. Obviously, I'm going to go into some detail and show how we're doing it with CloudFront. But for those customers, or in this case, ABC Company, they're already using an AWS. They're using our cloud for their origins. So they're already using these services. It's something that they know well. So our AWS WAF integrates seamlessly to these services. And so with that integration, depending on what you're looking to do, you can add bot control to CloudFront in this case. You can add fraud prevention. We have our managed rules, which I'll cover in more detail. And then we also have partner rules as well, which you'll see as I go through the demo. So as part of the demo, this is the whole kind of crux of what we're talking about, which is we need to deploy baseline security policy on a CloudFront distribution for ABC Loans because they're setting up a quick application. And so the way we're going to do that, I'm going to show two demos. The first demo will be for those more security-minded individuals. We're going to build policy within AWS WAF. The second way we're going to build and deploy policy is within CloudFront. And it's a new feature we launched, which is a one-click deployment that will give a baseline security managed rules. And so that baseline security managed rules that we're going to be covering in both demos are, first, the Amazon IP reputation list, which we get a lot of questions from customers on this. This is the intelligence that we get from our Amazon retail site, all the bad actors and the bad IPs we see over there. We bundle that up as a managed rule and put that in our WAF. So that's going to be one of them. We're also going to do our core rule set, which translates to what we're doing to protect for OWASP top 10 for some of those known vulnerabilities that are out there. And the third managed rule that we're going to deploy will be known bad inputs, which we're just looking for those inputs that are similar to like bots that are looking to find holes and vulnerabilities in applications. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to deploy these three managed rules in two different ways, and we're going to walk through the demos now. So hopefully, let's see how this works. Okay, so for the first one, I'm deploying this within WAF. And so I go to WAF. You can search WAF in the search bar within the console. The first thing that comes up is we have our WAF console. You'll see Shield Advanced at the bottom, so which goes hand in hand with our WAF, and also our firewall managers at the bottom as well. So if you're looking to deploy and manage policy globally, you can use Firewall Manager. But for this case, we're building a baseline security by creating a web ACL. So I'm gonna go over here and choose Create Web ACL in the AWS WAF. And the first thing I'm gonna do is reposition this to focus on CloudFront distributions because it's a global service. So once I do that, it's gonna reset because it's a global service, and now we're gonna do the simple steps it takes to deploy this baseline policy. The first thing I'm gonna do is name the policy, and this is gonna be important for this demo, and you'll see why in the end, but I'm gonna call this CloudFront Baseline Policy, and then that's gonna automatically add the CloudWatch metric name. I've already selected the CloudFront distribution, and a new feature to WAF is adding the body size limit that you want to inspect. You can choose that here. And then if I had CloudFront distributions already created in my environment, we would see that here. But because we don't have to add a resource. We're just building that policy as of right now, and we can deploy the policy later to our CloudFront distribution. So we're going to go next. And so now we need to add the filters, the rules, the three rules that I talked about. And we're going to do that here. So we do the dropdown for add rules. We can add manage rules, or we can build all the custom rules that we want, whether it's a rate-based rule, whatever we want to do. But in this case, we're going to build manage rules. Right here, you can see all of our manage rules. We're going to go into some detail on our AWS manage rules, but you see we have partners that are here that have manage rules in our firewall, so you can add that for layered security. But in this case, we're going to focus on our AMRs. So at the top, when you expand that, we have our premium rules for bot control. We have our account takeover prevention, which is more fraud prevention. We also have our bot control. And as we, for the rules we want to add, we're just selecting add to web ACL. In this case, this is bot control. So we have both common bots and targeted bots. Below that, you'll see our free AMRs. We have our core AMRs, which the three that we're going to add to this web policy will be from those. But as I scroll down, you'll also see we have situational AMRs as well, whether you're doing a WordPress application or a SQL database. But now we're going to go back up and we're going to select the managed rules that I discussed in the very beginning, which is going to be our baseline security. So we are going to select the Amazon IP reputation list, which that's the intelligence we're getting from Amazon.com and other places. So we'll select that, which will add it to the policy. We'll also select core rule set, which is that OWASP top 10 rule set that focuses on vulnerabilities that adhere to OWASP top 10. We select that. And then we're also going to do known bad inputs, which again is looking for all the inputs that are trying to find ways into our application. So once we select that, now we scroll down and we hit add rules. And so now we're going to go to a quick summary of the rules that we're going to add for our baseline security policy. You can do some other stuff, like we're going to start in allow and look at count mode rather than put these in block mode. And there's some other stuff. So now we're going into the setting the rule priority. So for this example, the rule priority is not an issue. But if you are to choose like our bot rule, which is a premium rule, you can move that down the ranking so that you can lower the amount of requests that get to that premium rule. We'll then configure our metrics with some of the names. We're just going to use the standard recommendations here. We go to next. And now we're just looking at everything that we did as far as the policies that we've created in the summary. Once we hit create web ACL, Now our policy is created. So just to summarize, we just created a quick policy in WAF that we can add to CloudFront distributions when we want. And if you remember, I named it CloudFront Baseline Policy. So for those security-minded people in the crowd, this is how you can build detailed policy. So as you saw, we can do custom policy, we can add bot control, we can do all those things. But in this example, we're just doing a baseline security policy with the three AMRs that we mentioned. So now I'm going to do the same process from Amazon CloudFront, which is our CDN, which I discussed in one of the first slides. So what you're going to see here is we're going to apply the exact same three rules by using this one-click deployment in our Amazon CloudFront. So the same thing, if it's in your recents, you can select CloudFront. If not, you can search for CloudFront in searching for a service. And then once we do that, we're going to go to the CloudFront the UI. So we can see some distributions that are already created here. We're going to see on the side just standard AWS Council. You'll have some telemetry reports and analytics. But really what we're going to do here is we're going to create a new CloudFront distribution so that we can put in front of the application that we're building for ABC loans. And so when we do that, the first thing we're going to do is select our origin. So this is where the website that we want to build is being housed in an S3 bucket. So we're going to go ahead and select that as the origin that we're going to protect. So once we do that, there's some other optional stuff that you can add, you can configure within CloudFront. You can see whether it's looking at the origin access, we're looking at some of the cache policies as we want to bring the experience closer to customers, our users as they go for this website. You'll also see the ability to add CloudFront functions or Lambda functions right here. We're not going to go into that in for this demo. But then we get to the web application firewall policy section. And so all we're doing here is you can see the explanation of the three rules that this policy will add are the same rules that I've already discussed, the Amazon IP reputation, the core rule set, and the known bad inputs. All we're doing is we can select enable security protections. And by doing that, it's going to apply those three AMRs that we built in the first demo. And so it explains it there. You'll also have a price estimate calculator down below, which if you have an estimate or you know about how many requests you'll get to the application behind this CloudFront distribution, you can put it in there and it'll give you a look at the cost. At any rate, so we're going to select enable security protections while we're building this distribution. And it drops down to two things. First, you can put it in monitor mode if you'd like, and most of our customers do that. And then, most importantly, there's a section called use existing WAF configuration. So if you remember, in the first demo, I built the policy that is CloudFront baseline policy. And so for the security teams, you can build the policy within WAF and have that ready so that that option can be available for your builders. But at the same time, we don't have to go that route because if we just select enable security protections, it's going to automatically apply those three AMRs that we covered for baseline security. So we have some other standard configurations. And then once we hit create, now we've created a CloudFront distribution that is in front of the application that we're building. And we've applied baseline security policy to that application via our AWS WAF. So just to summarize, so we had the use case, which was our bank that wanted to create the application. We had to move fast. We needed baseline security. We needed a good experience. So we did that with CloudFront and WAF, with the CloudFront distribution and applying some basic AMRs to that CloudFront distribution. The first demo, we showed how you can get into some detail if you want to build an extensive security policy, whether you want to add bot control, rate-based rules, et cetera. But we also showed in the second demo how if you're looking to build fast and you're more of maybe outside of the security team, you can add a baseline security policy just from creating your CloudFront distribution within Amazon CloudFront. So with that, that is it. I will be back here to ask the expert booth if you have any questions on how you build policy in WAF or on CloudFront. So thank you for your time. Have a good one.